Hi everyone, and welcome to another video on Windows 11. Since a few weeks, Microsoft has released their 22H2 update for Windows 11. This update has some new features and bug fixes. As you probably know by now, with the introduction of Windows 11 also came some restrictions on supported hardware, like the need for a fairly recent CPU, TPM 2.0 and Secure Boot. I did some videos on how to get around these limitations in the past, but seems like the 22H2 update changes some things in that area, and the original method to upgrade from Windows 10 to 11 on unsupported hardware is no longer working. In this video, I will explain how to still overcome that hardware check if you want to upgrade from a system currently running Windows 10. If you would be looking to do a fresh install or dual boot instead, the original workaround still works for the 22H2 version, and I'll put a card here and a link in the description for the video I did on that in case that's what you're looking for. If you are already running Windows 11 on unsupported hardware, you will probably notice that you will not get the 22H2 update offered. The workaround that I will explain here in this video for Windows 10 actually works as well for that situation. Nevertheless, for clarity, I cover this again in a separate video. I'll put a card here as well and a link in the description for that video I did on that. Now for this video, upgrading from Windows 10 to Windows 11 22H2. The goal is to keep all your files and applications as they are. If you're currently on Windows 10, Home or Pro, you will probably see a message in Windows Update about upgrading to Windows 11. The PC Health Check application can be used to find out if that's actually possible and give some more details. For example, on this Dell Optiplex 9020, which I will use for the rest of the video, it tells us that this machine does not have a supported CPU, no TPM 2.0 and no secure boot. So, when trying to run the upgrade from the installation media for Windows 11, it basically tells us the same thing and we're not able to continue. To work around this limitation in the past, we could simply delete a file called upraiseres.dll and there would not be any hardware check. With the 22H2 release, this method no longer works, and if you would try to use it, you would see the following. Fortunately, it's not very hard to fix this. The only difference in the procedure is that now we will need to replace the file with a version that is always telling that the hardware is fine, rather than just removing it. This method works for both Windows 10 Home and Pro, and after upgrading, if you have an activated system on Windows 10, the new version will be activated as well. To start, we need to download the Windows 11 22H2 ISO. You could simply download the ISO from Microsoft's website, but this can lead to a mismatch with the language version of your original Windows 10 installation. By using the media creation tool instead, it will detect the correct version and there is more chance for success. So on the Windows 11 download page, for which you can also find a link in the description, click on Download Now in the Create Windows 11 Installation Media section. Once downloaded, open the file from your downloads folder. Accept the licensing terms and leave the recommended version as is selected automatically. As mentioned, this prevents a language mismatch, which would not allow you to keep your files during the upgrade. In the next screen, choose to download the ISO file rather than creating installation media, and save it in your downloads folder as well. After that, the media creation tool is downloading the required files, which can take some time. Once completed, click Finish and navigate to where you decided to save the ISO file. We can mount this ISO by simply double-clicking on it. As you can see, this creates an extra virtual DVD drive on this computer, representing the ISO file which we downloaded. Since we will need to replace the file here, we will first need to copy all of the contents of the mounted ISO to a new folder on the desktop. Let me first create that folder. I'll call it Win11, and then we can, from the DVD drive, select all files and copy them in that Win11 folder. There we go, all files are now copied to the Win11 folder. Since we have a copy, we no longer need the ISO, so we can right-click on the virtual DVD drive and choose Eject. If you're short on space, you can now also delete the file from your downloads folder. At this point, we need to replace the upraiserrest.dll file. This file is located in the sources folder, as you can see, and it is responsible for the hardware check. You can download the modified version of this file from my blog, where, by the way, you can also find everything that I'm telling here written out in detail, and I'll also provide a direct link to the file in the description. Once the zip file is downloaded with the modified upraiserrest.dll, open it and simply drag it into the sources folder and confirm that you want to replace the file. To double check, make sure that the file size in the sources folder now is 192 kilobytes. That's all we had to do to work around the hardware checks. Now we can just launch setup.exe from the Win11 folder. In the first step, do make sure to disable any updates as it might undo the replaced file. To do so, go to Change How Setup Download Updates and check Not Right Now. If this doesn't work or you want to be very sure, you can also disconnect the cable or disconnect from Wi-Fi. The rest of the steps should be pretty straightforward. Accept the licensing terms, and if all goes well, you should see the following screen. Click Install here to continue with the upgrade. Once you do, the upgrade will take place and your current installation will become Windows 11. This takes a bit of time and one or more reboots. I think it was around 15 minutes on this machine. If your user is password protected, you will need to log in at some point as well. Eventually, if all goes fine, you should be greeted with your trusty desktop, but this time running on Windows 11. About this PC, as you see, shows us clearly that we are on Windows 11 22H2, still with the same unsupported hardware. As I mentioned in the beginning, the installation stays activated as it was as well. And in case you would be curious, updates seem to work fine as well, probably until the next big feature update, but only time can tell. And Microsoft. That's it for the video. At this point, you can also safely delete the folder that we created on the desktop. And as you can see, we can immediately take use of some of the improvements introduced in 22H2. Hope this has helped you to upgrade from Windows 10 to Windows 11. If you have enjoyed this video, feel free to give me a like. Or if you're interested in more of the same, don't hesitate to subscribe to my channel. Thanks again, and hope to see you back here soon.